In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet Angle Bisectors of a Triangle. Now, an angle bisector essentially divides an angle in half. So here's our angle. You can see that this is 90 degrees. So an angle bisector would intersect, making one angle 45 degrees and another angle 45 degrees. So that angle bisector would make each new angle congruent. In numbers 1 and 2, it states that each figure shows a triangle with one of its angle bisectors. So in number 1, you can see that segment that bisects angle SUT is this segment UP. So that means that this angle SUP is congruent to this angle TUP. So since SUT, that entire angle, equals 34, then the measure of angle 1 plus the measure of angle 2 equals 34, and they're both the same measure since they're congruent. So if we take the measure of angle SUT, that's equal to the measure of angle 1 plus the measure of angle 2, angle SUP plus angle TUP. Now we know, since they're congruent, that the measure of angle 1 is equal to the measure of angle 2. So we can plug the measure of angle 1 in for the measure of angle 2. So we can say that the measure of angle SUT equals 2 times that measure of angle 1. And since the measure of angle SUT equals 34 degrees, all we have to do is divide that by 2 to equal the measure of angle 1. So 34 degrees divided by 2 will give us 17. So 17 degrees equals the measure of angle 1. So here we have 17 degrees, and the measure of angle 2 is also 17 degrees. In number 2, it says find the measure of angle SQR if the measure of angle 2 equals 13 degrees. So this time we're looking for SQR, this larger angle, knowing that since QP is the segment that bisects the angle SQR, and 2 is going to be congruent to 1, and 2 is 13 degrees. So the measure of angle 2 plus the measure of angle 1 will equal the measure of angle SQR. We also know that the measure of angle 1 is equal to the measure of angle 2 since they're congruent. The measure of angle 2 is 13 degrees, therefore the measure of angle 1 is equal to 13 degrees. So we'll plug 13 degrees in for the measure of angle 1 and 13 degrees in for the measure of angle 2 to get the measure of angle SQR. 13 plus 13 is 26. So 26 degrees is equal to the measure of angle SQR for number 2. Our next set of directions says that each figure shows a triangle with its three angle bisectors intersecting at point P. So where each of those angle bisectors intersect is point P. Now the angle bisector theorem states that if a point is on the bisector of an angle, then it is equidistant from the sides of that angle. So because of the angle bisector theorem, if I were to pick a point on this bisector, let's say the bisector PF, since it's an angle bisector to TFE, if I were to pick this point here, or really any point along that bisector, then it is the same distance from one side as it is the other side. So this distance is congruent to this distance. And that also applies at the point where all those bisectors meet. So this distance is congruent to this distance. And it will be the same if we were to look at the other angle bisector. If we were to look at DP, that bisects EDT, this point along this line is the same distance from DT as it is to DS. So you can see that PT is congruent to PU and congruent to PS. So if we're given that PT is equal to 3, then PU, since PU is congruent to PT, PU is also 3. Let's move on to number 4. In number 4, we have to find PV if PW is equal to 7. So PW is this segment here, and that is equal to 7. We know that PW is congruent to PX and is also congruent to PV, because P is the intersection of all those angle bisectors, so that point P is the same distance from segment HF as it is from segment GF and segment HG. So PW is congruent to PX and is also congruent to PV. Since they're congruent, that means that PV is equal to the measure of PW, so PV is also equal to 7. So 7 is my solution in number 4. In number 5, I'm finding PW if PX is 5. So we can see PX is this segment here, and that segment is 5, and PX is congruent to PW, which is congruent to PY. Therefore, PW is equal to PX, so PW is equal to 5, since PW is congruent to PX. Moving on to number 6, we have to find PD if PC is equal to 8. PC, this segment here, is 8, and we know that each of these segments, PC, is congruent to PB, which is congruent to PD, since point P is the point at which all angle bisectors intersect or meet, so this is the same distance or equidistance from each of the sides of a triangle. So P is the same distance from RQ as P is from RS, and P is from SQ. So PD is equal to PC, and we're given that PC equals 8, so PD is also equal to 8 in number 6. In number 7, we're given that PY is 2, and we're also given that HP is 3. And it's asking us to find HY. Well, since HF is a straight line and PY intersects HF at 90 degrees, that means that this angle is also 90 degrees, angle PYH. So you can see we have a right triangle. So we're going to use the Pythagorean theorem and solve for HY. We briefly went over the Pythagorean theorem in algebra 1 and 2, so let's quickly go over it again. We have the A squared plus B squared equals C squared, where A and B are the legs of a right triangle and C is the hypotenuse. So we have A, B, and C. Our hypotenuse is directly across from that right angle, so in this case PH or HP, which is 3, so we'll plug 3 in for C. A is our unknown, and B, our other leg, is 2. So A squared plus B squared, 2 squared, equals C squared, which is 3 squared. So A squared plus 4 equals 9. When I subtract 4 from both sides, I get that A squared is equal to 9 minus 4, which is 5. So now I'm going to take the square root of both sides. So A is equal to the square root of 5, which the square root of 5 is 2.236, which is approximately 2.24, or 2 and 24 hundredths. So A, which is our HY, is equal to 2.24. Now let's move on to number 8. And number 8, it's asking us to find AP, so here is AP, if PQ is 1, PQ is 1, and AR is 2. So we have two sides of a right triangle, since this angle is 90 degrees. Since 90 degrees plus 90 degrees is 180, which forms this straight line. So we have two sides of a right triangle, where one is our unknown of AP, which is our hypotenuse, so that's our C. However, we're given that PQ is equal to 1, and PQ is the same distance as PS and PR. So that means that PR is also 1. So now we have the other side of our triangle. One leg is 1, the other leg of our triangle is 2, and our unknown is C. So A squared plus B squared equals C squared. That's going to be PR squared plus AR squared equal to C squared, which is AP. So PR is 1, so we have 1 squared plus AR which is 2 squared, and that's equal to AP squared. 1 squared is 1, plus 2 squared is 4, and that's equal to AP squared. So 1 plus 4 is 5, and that's equal to AP, that segment squared. So if we take the square root of that, the square root of 5 is 2.24, and that is equal to AP. So 2.24 is our solution in number 8. So I'll go ahead and stop the video here. Join me in the next video where I'll finish out this worksheet completing numbers 9 through 16. And if you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment below. Also, if you need further explanation on the angle bisector theorem, go to my geometry tutorial section on YouTube, where I give more in-depth explanation of each of the terms used in this video. And as always, don't forget to click that like button and subscribe to my channel.